All right.
Hi, everyone.
Okay, in this session, we'll see how we can count any given character in the given string. So, this is a very common interview question for Java programming. Like, let's say we have a given string. As you can see on the screen, Java is object oriented language. So let's say if interviewer asks you, can you count the number of characters of A, right? So I can see if I count manually, so A has come here 1, 2, 3, 4, which means count of occurrence of character A in the given string is 4. Same way, let's say I want to count L, right? So L is not present here, L is not present here, so L is present here only, which means the count of character L is 1. Okay, so this is the problem. You are given one string, one sentence, and you have to count the occurrence of any given character. So we have, for example, we have taken example of A and L, so it could be anything, right? So let's see how we can solve this problem. Okay, before jumping into the code, let's try to think logically how we can solve this problem. Okay, we know we have to count character, which means our result should be a number, right? In case of A, it should be 4, in case of L, it should be 1. So our output should be number. And we know in a string class there is a method length. So using the length method, we can count the length of the string. So if I use str.length, so it will give me the length of this complete string, means 4 plus 6, likewise, whatever the length, complete length, it will give us str.length method. Same way, let's say if we, there's also one more method, replace all. So we can replace any character or any string with the replacement. So what if we use replace all method and we replace the character of which we want the count? So if I replace, let's say, A, right? So resultant string would be something like this. Let me write it quickly for you. For example, let's say I have replaced A from the given string. So my string would become JV, because A I have replaced is object oriented L, A I have replaced N, G, U, again A, we can skip A, G. So for example, I have replaced A with blank, right? So I have replaced A with blank. So our after replacement string would be like something like this. As you can see, the length. So my question to you is, whose length is more, the original string or the string in which we have replaced A with the blank? Yes, you are right. The this original string will have length more, because it contains more correct. I mean, A is there, and it will have lesser length because we have replaced some characters, in fact a character, with blank. And a very common sense says, if we subtract the length of original string with this, it will give us the count of A, correct? It's pretty simple, right? Our original problem was we have to count the number of character A. And with this logic, with this approach, we can solve this problem, right? So that's what I'm gonna use. So in one line you can write the answer. So let me show you the code. I have already written the code. So this is the code. It's pretty simple. So this is the implementation of what we have discussed so far. str.length, it will give us the length of complete string. Then I have used replace all method, and I am replacing a with blank and then getting the length. So this will, this whole highlighted thing will give the count of this thing, and I'm using minus operator here just to separate both the numbers, both the length, and it will give us the result. So let me quickly run this to show you the demo. So in this example we are replacing a with blank, which means it will give the length of occurrence of it will give the count of occurrence of character a. Let's run it. As you could see in the output console, it is 4. Let's say I want to calculate the occurrence of O. Manually I can count O is 2 times, so let's verify. So if I want to count O, let's see what our program sees the output. It's giving 2, which is correct, right? Let's say I want to count I, for example, I character. So I could replace this and we can count. So I has occurred 2 times. The idea is simple. We have to find the length of original string minus the length of the string, which is the resultant of replacement of the character in the question. So this is the way we can solve this problem. And that's what I wanted to discuss in this session today. And thank you so much. Bye bye.